Hallelujah.
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 That's why we read Galatians chapter 6 verse 8 onwards. To what you sow, you reap. After listening to all that, no, I will hold on. How can you say, Father, you know, my husband, I trusted him. That fellow stupid, he has become like that. My sister, I loved, and she has forgotten all that. If you want to go, talk. I can't help it out. What you sow to your mind, plenty of the seeds of the world will be available for you. The worldly seeds are available to you. But heavenly seeds, you have to take it by yourself. That is the difference. Jesus said in John 14:30, the ruler of the world is coming behind me, but he has no power over me.
Amen.
He has no power over me. Wherever you go, you are in the world, you are not in heaven. Not yet. There won't be all these things. Temptation, trials, sin, all those things will be there. Even if you are 75 years old or 85 years old, when you see a young girl, you may feel like something. A lust may come because it is not that you who, another enemy is after you. You should realize. Yes. Paul said in the book of Romans chapter 7 verse 15 onwards, what I want to do, I am not able to do. What I am not supposed to do, I am doing. In which age? Even in your 95 years old. Because the enemy is there. Enemy is in the world. He can only corrupt you. Only God can purify you.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
So the corruption work will be going on. No, that sound is coming. This sound is coming. How? That will come because you are in the world. You take... Sound has to be overcome by sound. Thorn has to be overcome by thorns. Immediately take the word, I can do everything through Christ who strengthens me.
Amen.
It is not I who live. My Lord lives in me. Amen. You have to take the word of God. You have to fill with light. If you don't want, no. Again, that sound comes. This sound comes. That fellow has done. Nope. Till you died, the enemy will attack you. The enemy will be after you. That is his work. He wants your soul. He wants your family. But you have to be where you are. Feed yourself with who God is and what he has done for you. Praise God by what he is. Thank God for what he has done for you. Whatever may be issue, surrender your life to God. So these three things have to continue in your life. There are many issues you may not understand what to do. There are many struggles you may not know where to go, how to handle it. But know your God is with thanksgiving offered to God, and the peace of God will abide in you. Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 onwards. Don't be worried about anything else. In all things, make known your petition to the Lord. And the peace of God will abide in you. So surrender your life to Him. Many things you may not understand, but surrender to God and move on in life. Once you are given to God, don't again go back. Some people come to the church with a burden and then they cry to God. And then again they go back sad. I asked, have you come to church to show your problem to Jesus? Yeah, I showed. Then now, why are you going sad? I'm carrying it back. What to do? I have to carry this cross. Then why did he come to the church? No, I give it to the church. God. Huh? How is it? You want to give it to God? Again, you are carrying. Yes, Father, I didn't give anything. Huh? So take care. God loves you. So, what do you sow? If you sow sadness, fear, worries, you will reap what sadness and fear. You are the one to be courageous. You are the one God has chosen you to bring His light, His courage, His strength to the world. That's why St. Paul says in 2 Timothy 1:7, you have not received the spirit of fear that belongs to that fellow. Why are you frightened? If you are frightened, you remain that only. Nobody will help you. You have to come out. You have not received the spirit of fear, but courage, love, self-discipline. You have to, you don't feed yourself with the word of God. So he dares to. When does the weed come? When you don't plant the field with crop. If you're planting with the crop, will the weeds come? Even if they come, you can pluck it away. Why they are coming? Because you are not planting. You are not bringing God's presence. You are not praising God. You are not thanking God. You are not worshiping God. You are not telling, Lord, how great you are. You are not telling, Lord, what you have done to me and my family. You are not praising. You are not entering into the presence. Let anything happen, Lord, I surrender to you. When I surrender to you, you have taken control of it. You will take care of it, ante. Now I need not be afraid, worried. I have given to you. You are a living God. You have heard my prayer. Yes. We have a beautiful prayer in the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 20 verse 12, I think. Jehoshaphat's prayer. And he says three things. Lord, the enemy who is coming against me is very strong. It's a very powerful army is coming. Second, in this moment of confusion, I don't know what to do. The enemy is big and I don't know what to do. But in this time, I do something. What is that? But my eyes are upon you.
Amen. Hallelujah.
But my eyes are on upon you. My mind doesn't know what to do. It is getting confused. My eyes don't know what to do because plenty of my life, I don't know what to do because plenty of enemies are coming. But my eyes are upon you. Praise the Lord. What is that? 20 verse 12? Okay. We are powerless against the multitude that comes. Yes.
We do not know what to do.
We do not know. Our mind doesn't know. Kya karna hai? Malum nahi padta. Kaisa karna? We don't know, understand what's happening. We don't know what to do. But
our eyes are on you.
But our eyes are on you. Our eyes are on you. We have prayed to you. We have surrendered to you. Hum sab kuch aapko chod diya. आप देखेंगे
Praise the Lord.
आप देख सकते हैं
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes. God will take care. You learn to surrender to God. So, what you sow to your mind is very important. To overcome the enemy, you have to be alert to sow praising God, thanking God, worshipping God, surrendering ourselves to God, and move on with His presence. Move on with His faith. What is faith? What is faith? Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. Faith means
anyone?
Your God is living God. He is not dead. He said in Revelation 1:18, look, I died, but now I am alive. I have the power, the key of the world and even the nether world. So nobody can touch my children. Zechariah 2:5-8. If anybody touches my child, it is as though they touch the apple of my eyes.
Amen. Amen.
I have put the wall of fire around you. So faith means to be aware that my God is living. Faith means whatever we have given to God, He is capable to take care of me.
Amen.
To do the needful.
Yes, Jesus.
That's why in the book of Timothy, chapter 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 12, he says, I know in whom I have trusted.